Bishop Joseph, the Auxiliary Bishop. May we request Archbishop Ramon Arguelles and Bishop Francis De Leon to join the two bishops on stage. We will begin our first day with the opening prayers, with the enthronement of the Bible, to be led by Father Ronilo Magao of the Apostolic Vicariate of Bontoc Lagawe and Father Edgar Omay of the Diocese of
Good afternoon, His Excellencies, Most Reverend Dominic Wen Chu, Most Reverend Joseph Dick Duke Dao, Most Reverend Francis De Leon, Most Reverend Ramon Arguelles, Monsignor Jerry Santos, Father Dominic Du, and beloved Vietnamese and Filipino priests, welcome to the 8th Summer Catechetical Institute for Priests here in the land of Vietnam. The land of locusts and bamboos, the easternmost country on the Indochina Peninsula in Southeast Asia. We ask our Lord Jesus Christ to bless this occasion with His wisdom and grace. We come to this gathering as ordained ministers seeking God's union with the theme of living the joy of the gospel, the Church in dialogue. We are reminded by our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that there is the joy of the moment when Jesus looked at us priests who were chosen to make an exodus from ourselves in order to center our life on Christ, on His gospel, on His will for us, laying aside our own plans in order to say with St. Paul, "It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me." Today, we'll be having the enthronement of the Bible and the image of Our Lady. Bible enthronement is a solemn act of reverence to the Word of God. The Word of God is one way in which we can encounter Jesus. In Evangelii Gaudium, it states that the joy of the Gospel fills the hearts and lives of all who encounter Jesus. Those who accept this offer of salvation are set free from sins, sorrow, inner emptiness, and loneliness. With Jesus Christ, joy is constantly born anew. In proclaiming the mystery of the good news, it transforms the life of the person who takes into heart. This transformation will lead the person to mission expanding horizons for the life of the Church. As servants of Christ and the Church, it is our way to pay honor and respect to the sacred scriptures as the Word of God. The Word of God touches our hearts, converting them to God. It is the Word of God that renews our communities. Likewise, the image of our Blessed Mother is upon the altar. We express our deep devotion to Our Lady of Immaculate Conception and her rosary as our guide closer to her Son, Jesus Christ. Our Blessed Mother Mary always reminds us to be attentive to God's Word. She herself is our great model of active listening and obedience to the will of the Father. Please all stand.
Thank you.
Dear God, from the beginning of time you have called us through Jesus Christ to listen to your word and act upon it. Our being here today gives witness to the word that we have listened to. Create within us attitudes of openness, humility, and receptivity, so that we may be ready to listen deeply and be guided by your word in all our undertakings under this four-day conference. We pray this through the intercession of the Blessed Mother, in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, the Word made flesh among us now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated.
First reading, an invitation to grace. Reading from the prophecy of the prophet Isaiah. For just as from the heaven the rain and snow come down, and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to him who sows and bread to him who eats, so shall my word be that goes from my mouth. It shall not return to be void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
All stand for the proclamation of the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. Wikain mo poon, nakikinig ako sa iyong mga salita. Alleluia, alleluia.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you.
You are the salt of the earth, but what if salt goes flat? How can you restore its flavor? Then it is good for nothing but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Men do not light a lamp and then put under the bushel basket. They set it on a stand where it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, your light must shine before men so that they may see goodness in your acts and give praise to your Heavenly Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Please be seated. All stand. Mm-hmm.
Let us now implore God, our loving Father, who bestow on us the grace to respond to His word. That our Holy Father, Pope Francis, Pope Benedict XVI, our bishops, priests, deacons, and missionaries, as ministers of the word, they may be guided by the Holy Spirit in communicating God's saving message to all. Let us pray to the Lord and say, Lord, make us open to your word.
Lord, make us open to your word.
That the word of God may build community in us and among the people given to our care, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, make us open
to your word. That Vietnamese priests and people will be guided always by the word of life, let us pray to the Lord. That in our families, communities, parishes, and schools, the Bible may become the source of Christian life, of love and service. Let us pray to the Lord. That we may find in His word guidance and strength and witnessing to the good news in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord. Gathering our prayers, let us all sing Ama Namin. Ama Namin, sumasalamin ka, sambahin ang alam mo, mapasa amin ang kaharian mo.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, Word of God from all eternity, we praise and thank you for giving us this opportunity to celebrate your word. Thank you for choosing us to share your word of life to others. Help us to become individuals and communities based on your word. This we ask of you, who live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. May the word of Christ, in all its richness, dwell in our hearts, so that we may be able to instruct and admonish each other in all wisdom and joyfully sing the praises of God. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful God bless us all, the Father and the Son.